Today's topic is decomposition of organic matter. We all know that when plant residues are returned to the soil, various organic compounds undergo decomposition. And in this video, I'm going to discuss about the organic matter decomposition and types of decomposition procedure and the soil food web. Hi, I am Manti. Let's begin the topic. First of all, we had to know that what is decomposition. Decomposition kya hai? Decomposition is the first stage in the recycling of nutrients that have been used by an organism. Organism kya kya ho sakte? It may be plants or animals to build its body. So, it is the process whereby the dead tissue break down and are break down into simpler organic forms. These are the food source for many of the species at the basis of ecosystem. These species that may carry out the process of decomposition are known as detritivores. Detritivores means feeders on dead or decaying organic matter. Many of these decomposer species function in tandem or parallel with one another, which is responsible for a species part of the decomposition process, and they are collectively known as detritivore community. Next, what are the characteristics of a decomposer? Main characteristics kya hai? That it can break down organic material. और कौन कौन ब्रेक करने में हेल्प करते हैं? बैक्टीरिया एंड फंजाइ. दिस ऑर्गेनिजम्स कैरी आउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिकम्पोजिशन व्हिच अ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म अंडरगो आफ्टर इट्स डेथ. इन रिसेंट टाइम्स मैन हैज अटेम्प्टेड टू कंट्रोल एंड डायरेक्टली यूटिलाइज द प्रोसेस फॉर सैनिटरी रिसाइकलिंग एंड रिक्लेमेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट मटेरियल. Such organic material such as vegetable matter, animal manure and other organic refuse that can be converted from otherwise wasted material to a more stable form for the use of soil amendment by this process. This process is called composting and the final product of composting is called compost. Generally speaking, there are two types of processes. That is anaerobic decomposition. That is, this process is undergo without oxygen. And the another one is aerobic decomposition and stabilization. That is, in this process, oxygen is required. Next is about anaerobic decomposition. इसको हम लोग फर्मेंटेशन भी कह सकते हैं. वो एक नेचुरल प्रोसेस है. हेयर द डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिक मड एट द बॉटम ऑफ द मार्शेस एंड इज बारिड ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल टू व्हिच ऑक्सीजन डज नॉट रिक्वायर. यहाँ पे ऑक्सीजन की ज़रूरत नहीं है. इंटेंसिव रिडक्शन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मैटर बाय प्यूट्रिफिकेशन इज यूजुअली अकॉम्पेन्ड बाय डिसएग्रीडेबल ऑर्डर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड एंड व्हिच इज रिड्यूस्ड ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड व्हिच कंटेन सल्फर जैसे कि मार कैप्टेंस और कोई भी सल्फर कंटेनिंग ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड. Otherwise, this organism can use nitrogen, phosphorus or other nutrients for their survival or to develop cell protoplasm. But there they can reduce organic nitrogen to organic acid and ammonia by the process of nitrogen cycle, sulfur cycle or carbon cycle, which I will discuss in this video. The carbon and the organic compound which is not utilized in the cell protein, but it is liberated mainly in the reduced form of methane, that is CH4, which is a small portion of carbon and may be respired as carbon dioxide. Since anaerobic destruction of organic matter is a reduction process, the final product is humus, which is subject to some aerobic oxidation which put in the soil. That is, it may appear to decompose further after being exposed to the air. Next is about aerobic decomposition. By the name it suggests, here it requires oxygen. Aerobic means oxygen ki zarurat hai. So when an organic material decomposes in the presence of oxygen, this process is known as aerobic. The aerobic process is most common in nature. For example, it takes place on ground surface, such as forest floor, where dropping from trees and animals are converted into a relatively stable humus. There is no accompanying bad smell when there is adequate oxygen present. That is, aerobic decomposition mein oxygen ki zarurat hai to feed upon the organic matter. They can also use nitrogen, phosphorus, some of the carbon and other nutrient elements. Much of the carbon serves as a source of energy for the organism and is burned up and can respire as a carbon dioxide. Since carbon serves both as a source of energy and as an element for cell protoplasm. However, if the excess of carbon over nitrogen, that is carbon and nitrogen residue, is too high, then biological activity diminishes and several cycles of organism are then required to burn most of the carbon. Such as when some of the organisms die, their stored nitrogen and carbon becomes available for the other organism. Yes, other organisms use the nitrogen from the dead cells to form new cell material once more excess carbon is converted to carbon dioxide. Thus, the amount of carbon is reduced and the limited amount of nitrogen is recycled by the process of nitrogen cycle. Finally, when the ratio of available carbon to available nitrogen is in sufficient balance, at that time what happens? Nitrogen is released as ammonia by the process of this nitrogen cycle. Under favorable condition, some ammonia may oxidize to nitrate. Phosphorus, potash and various micronutrients are also essential for biological growth. These are normally present in more than one adequate amount. Next is about the requirement for efficient decomposition. It mainly depends on maintaining microbial activity or any factor which slows or halts microbial growth, which help in composting processes. It also occurs if the aeration, moisture, particle size and a sufficient carbon source and a nitrogen source is maintained. So first of all, oxygen is required to decompose organic waste, but this also we know that some decomposition does not takes place in presence of oxygen. It takes place in anaerobic condition. However, the process is slow and foul odor may develop in that case. Next is about adequate moisture is essential for microbial activity. A decomposed will not decompose efficiently. Proper moisture encourages the growth of microorganism so that it can break down organic matter into humus. That is the reason rainfall is required for decomposition procedure. Next is about particle size. It is also playing an important role in decomposition procedure. That is, grinding the organic material before decomposing greatly reduces decomposition time. The smaller the size of the organic refuses particle, the more quickly it can be consumed by the microbes. Next is about temperature. It is also play an important role to this biological activity. Low outside temperature reduces the activity down, while warmer temperature speed up decomposition. the microbes that make up the bulk of the decomposition process into two categories, that is mesophilic and thermophilic. Is about mesophilic, means those organisms which can function in 50 to 113 degree Fahrenheit, and thermophilic organism means those organism which can act on 113 to 158 degree Fahrenheit. So these are the organism which act on different temperature. Various investigators have shown that many different types of thermophilic bacteria apparently play a major role in decomposing protein and other organic matter. They appear to be responsible for the intense activity, which is characteristic of the first few days when the temperature reaches about 150 to 170 degree Fahrenheit, and major changes of the nature of the compost pile are takes place at that temperature. That is, when the pile is drastically shrinking and the appearance of the material is undergo rapid changes. Next is about chemical decomposers. It include bacteria, actinomycetes, protozoa, fungi. These organisms are the initial inhabitant of the pile. Many of the organisms are unseen and come in with the material that make up the pile. That is, bacteria is likely to be found in a compost heap and are aerobic bacteria that specialize in breaking down organic compound and can thrive in temperature ranging up to 170 degree Fahrenheit or in 77 degree centigrade. That is, this bacterial population differ from pile to pile depending upon the raw material of the compost, degree of the heat, and the amount of the air present, moisture, geographical location of the pile, and other important factors. That is, we all know that bacteria are the single-celled organism and are shaped like a spear, rod, or a spiral twist. I have made a separate lecture for this bacteria. If you want, you can see it from my channel. Next is about actinomycetes, which is responsible for the earthy smell in the spring season and is a higher form of bacteria, which is similar to fungi and a mold, which is responsible for the formation of humus. We all know that while most bacteria are found in the top foot of the soil, but this actinomycetes can work in the deep level of the soil. Deep under the roots, they can convert dead plant material to a peat-like substances while they are decomposing animal and vegetable matter. These actinomycetes can also liberate carbon, nitrogen, ammonia while making nutrients available for higher plants. They are also found on every natural substrate, and the majority are aerobic and are mesophilic. That is, 5% of the soil bacterial population is comprises of actinomycetes. So it plays an important role in soil microbiology. This is the reason why bacteria tend to die rapidly, as actinomycetes population grow in the compost pile, is that actinomycetes have the ability to produce antibodies, chemical substances, which can inhibit bacterial growth. Next is about protozoa, which is the simplest form of animal organism. They are single-celled and microscopic in size and are complex in their activities than the bacteria. A gram of soil can contain as millions of protozoa, but a gram of compost had made 1,000 less. Especially during the thermophilic stage, these protozoa obtain their food from organic matter in the same way bacteria does. But because they are present in far fewer number than a bacteria, that they can play a smaller part in the composing process. Next is about fungi. They are many-celled, filamentous or single-celled primitive plants. Unlike more complex green plants, they lack chlorophyll and therefore lack the ability to make their own carbohydrate. Most of them are classified as saprophytes because of their survival activity. That is, they live on dead or dying material and can obtain energy by breaking down organic matter in dead plants and animals. Next is about the physical decomposers, that the larger organism that can chew and grind their way through the compost heap are higher up in the food chain and are known as physical decomposers. The following is a rundown of some of the larger physical decomposers that may help in nearly any compost heap. Most of these creatures function rest at medium or mesophilic temperature. Next is about mites, which are related to ticks, spiders and crabs because they have a common six-leg-like jointed appendages. They can be free-living or parasitic, sometimes both at once. Some mites are smaller enough to be invisible by the naked eye, while some tropical species are even up to half inch in length. So, these are some larger physical decomposers which help in physical decomposition. Next is about the classification of soil organism. It can be microorganism, macroorganism and plants. Microflora and microfauna comes under microorganism. And mesoorganisms and macroorganisms comes under macroorganism, and algae and roots are comes under plants. Then this bacteria and fungi, which comes under microflora, and its size is less than 5 micrometer. And then protozoa and nematodes are microfauna, and its size is less than 100 micrometer. And then springtails and mites are comes under mesoorganism, and its size it ranges between 100 micrometer to 2 millimeter. And then earthworms, millipedes, wood dye, snails or slugs, it comes under macroorganism, and its sizes ranges from 2 to 20 millimeter, whereas algae sizes it ranges from 10 micrometer. And roots may be more than 10 micrometer. So these are the classification of soil organism. Next is about the decomposition process. Fresh residues consist of recently decreased amount of microorganisms, insects and earthworms and many other materials. But crop residues contain mainly complex carbon compound, which is originated from cell walls. That may be cellulose or hemicellulose. That we all know that the chains of carbon with each carbon atom linked to other carbon from the backbone of the organic molecule. And this carbon chain with varying amounts of attached oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, phosphorus and sulfur, which are the basic for both simple sugars and amino acids, and are more complicated molecule of long carbon chain or rings. Depending on their chemical structure, decomposition is rapid or slow. That is, the decomposition of sugar, starch and protein is rapid, but the decomposition of cellulose, fats, waxes and resins are slow, but very slow at the case of lignin. But this decomposition process is also depend on the microbial activity. So, microbes play an important role in this process. Next is about the function in carbon cycling. That is, soil has a crucial function in the global carbon cycle, with the global soil carbon pool estimated to be 2500 gigatons, whereas This is the 3.3 times the amount of the atmospheric pull at 750 gigatons and 4.5 times the biotic pull at 560 gigatons. So, this is the pull of organic carbon, which occurs primarily in the form of a SOM, accounts for approximately 1550 gigatons of the total global carbon pool, with the soil inorganic carbon, which is accounting for the remainder. Next, the pool of the organic carbon, which exists in dynamic equilibrium between grains and losses, whereas soil may therefore serve as either a sink of source of carbon or throw a greenhouse gas emission respectively, depending on exogenous factor. That is, soil can store 3 times more carbon than exists in the atmosphere. Plant can absorb atmospheric carbon during photosynthesis, so the return of the plant residues in the soil contributing to soil carbon. While much of this carbon ultimately returns to the atmosphere as soil microbes decompose, carbon-based plant biomasses and release carbon dioxide. This soil carbon stores can increase if the rate of carbon increases the rate of microbial decomposition. So, the carbon requisition refers to this process of storing carbon in soil organic matter and thus removing carbon dioxide from the nature. That is, biochar is processed from burning organic material at high temperature with little to no oxygen ability. The potential of utilizing biochar to sequester carbon in the soil has received considerable research attention in recent years as part of efforts to develop climate-smart agricultural practices. Next, carbon is the foundation of all life on Earth. It required to form complex molecules like proteins and DNA. The carbon cycle describes the process in which carbon atom continues travel from the atmosphere to the earth and then back into the atmosphere. Carbon can move from atmosphere to plants. In atmosphere, carbon gaseous stage mein hote hai, jaise ki in the form of carbon dioxide. Through the process of photosynthesis, this carbon dioxide is used, and then this carbon moves from plants to animal through a food chain. The carbon that is in plants moves to the animal and then eat them. In the decomposition process, different products are released, that is carbon dioxide, energy, water, plant nutrients, and a resynthesized organic carbon compound. Successive decomposition of dead material and modified organic matter results in the formation of a more complex organic matter called humus, and the process is known as humification. Humus affect soil properties. Soil में जितने सारे organic materials रहते हैं वो as a food use करते हैं. कौन use करते हैं? Microorganism which are present in soil. As they break down the organic matter, any excess nutrients, that is nitrogen, phosphorus or sulfur, are released in the soil in the form that plant can use. This process is known as mineralization. By breaking down carbon structure and revealing new ones or storing the carbon into own biomass, here soil biota plays a most important role in nutrient cycle processing and thus in the ability of a soil to provide the crop with sufficient nutrient to harvest the healthy product. The organic matter content, especially the more stable humus, increases the capacity to store water and store carbon from the atmosphere by the process of carbon cycle. Next is about the essential functions which is performed by different members of soil microorganism. That is, it can maintain soil structure, by bioturbinating invertebrates and planktons by the help of the mycorrhizae and other microorganisms. Next, it helps in the regulation of soil hydrological processes by most bioturbinating invertebrates and plant roots. Next, it can help in gas exchange and carbon accumulation in soil. It can be done by mostly microorganism and plant roots. Next, this soil organism can play an important role in soil detoxification and nutrient cycle, and it can help in decomposition of organic material by the help of various saprophytic and litter feeding invertebrates, that is detritivores, or by the help of fungi, bacteria, actinomycetes and other microorganisms. It can help in the suppression of pests, parasites and diseases also by the help of the plant's mycorrhizae and other fungi, nematodes, bacteria and other microorganisms, that is Colembola, earthworms and various predators. Next, it can also help for the source of food and medicine. For example, this actinomycetes can help for the production of antibiotics. Next, it can act as a symbiotic and asymbiotic relationship with plants and their roots. Here, rhizobia, mycorrhizae, actinomycetes, diazotropic bacteria and various other rhizopheric microorganisms are helpful. Next, during the decomposition process, microorganisms convert the carbon structure of fresh residues into transformed carbon product in the soil. There are many different types of organic molecule in the soil. Some are simple molecules that have been synthesized directly from the plants or other living organisms. Next is about priming effect. Though a number of studies has been observed an increase in the rate of organic matter decomposition which follows biochar application. Biochar application मैंने थोड़ी देर पहले इसी में ही describe किया था. So, this process को क्या कहते हैं? Priming effect, which complicates any effort to sequester carbon as it can increase in microbial activity and it could result in decomposition rate which increases carbon input rate. While the exact mechanism responsible for this effect has not been conclusively identified, but it may result from the stimulation of microbial activity as microbes can utilize carbon and nitrogen which is present in biochar. This biochar remains as a hot topic with regards to increasing soil carbon stores. So, this is all about today. Today I have discussed about the characteristics of the decomposition of organic matter, then the types of the decomposition, then the requirement for efficient decomposition, and then the organic matter which is responsible for decomposition, and in the last about its priming effect. So, this is all about today. Thank you for watching this video.